Good morning, students. Today I'm gonna teach 6th maths 3rd chapter, playing with numbers, continuation of the previous video. So last class I have taught what is mean by divisibility. So now divisibility by 2. So without actually dividing, by seeing the number itself, you have to say whether it is divisible by 2 or not. So how will you say? You have to see what? A number is divisible by 2 if it has any of the digits 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 in its ones place. So if you have given any number, so you have to see the units place. For example, I'll show with one example. This is one example. Without dividing, by seeing the number itself, you have to say whether it is divisible by 2 or not. So how will you see? You have to check the units place. Units or what you say? Ones place. You will call this as unit or ones place, right? You have to see in this units place, these numbers should be there. 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Any of this number is there in the units, then you can say that it is divisible by 2. Here 2. 2 is there, right? So it is divisible by 2. One more example I'll take. Now see the units place. It is 3. 3 is not there, right? So this is not divisible by 2. So how this came? How you can say that seeing the units place, we can say that it is divisible or not? This is of 2, right? So you check the multiples of 2, what you will get? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, etc. Right? Now see the numbers. 2, 4, 6, 8. In the 2 digits numbers, you have to see the unit place only. 0. See? 2, 4, 6, 8, 0. Then again what it comes? 2. Again 4, 6, 8. See? The numbers are that itself, right? 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. So 22. 22 is also a multiple of 2. What it came to? So in the multiples of 2, in the units place, you will get this number itself. So while checking, we have to see the units place. In that units place, if you have these numbers 0, 2, or 4, or 6, or 8. In these 5 numbers, if any number comes at the units place, then you can say that it is divisible by 2. Next, divisibility by 3. Now, for the 3 you have to see. What it says, if the sum of the digits is a multiple of 3, then the number is divisible by 3. So what you have to see, if they have given any number, you have to add those digits. Then that sum means what? You have to add. After adding, you will get, no, that we call it as sum. For example, if you have a number 221, what you have to check whether it is divisible by 3. Then what you have to do is, first you have to add this 2 digit number. 2, what you have to do? 2 plus 1, how much? 3. This is called sum, right? So that sum, you have to see what? Sum of the digits is a multiple of 3. Whether it is a multiple of 3? Yeah, right. This is a multiple of 3. 3 is a multiple of 3. So this is divisible by 3. One more example we can take. Which? 25. Whether it is divisible by 3, you have to check. What you have to do? You have to add those 2 digit number. 2 plus 5 is 7. Whether 7 is a multiple of 3, whether sum 7 comes in the table of 3, no, right? So it is not divisible by 3. Let me take one more example. Is 7221 is divisible by 3? So like this, if question comes, is 7221 divisible by 3, then what you have to do? First step you have to do is you have to add the digits. 7 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1. what you will get? 7 plus 2, 9. 9 plus 2, 11. 11 plus 1, 12. Now, you got the sum. Whether 12 is divisible by 3? Yeah, right? 3 how much are? 3 fours are 12. So, 12 is a multiple of 3, right? So, we can say that 12 is, therefore, 7,221 is divisible by 3. Understood how to check the divisibility of 3? You have to add it and the last what sum you will get, that should be a multiple of 3. If it is a multiple of 3, then we can say that it is divisible by 3. Next, divisibility by 6. You have to check the divisibility of 6. So what it says, if a number is divisible by 2 and 3 both, then it is divisible by 6 also. So it says that if a number, if you have given with the number, if it is divisible by 2 and also 3, divisibility by 2 and divisibility by 3, if it is divisible by 2 and 3, then we can say that it is also divisible by 6. Let me explain with one example. So I'll take first example as 18. Okay, whether it is divisible by 2, what you have to do, what you have to see for the divisibility by 2, you have to see the units place. What is there? 8. Whether 8, what divisibility by 2 says, 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 should be there in the units place. Now in the units place, 8 itself is there, so we can say that it is divisible by 2, right? By 2. Then what you have to see for whether it is divisible by 3 also. For checking for 3, what you have to do? You have to add the digits, right? 1 plus 8 is what? 9. And then what you have to see, this sum, whether this sum is multiple of 3, whether 9 is a multiple of 3, right? It is a multiple of 3, right? 3 3s are 9. So we can also say that it is divisible by 3. Now it is, this 18 is divisible by 2 and divisible by 3 also. So we can say that 18 is divisible by 6. Okay, if a given number is divisible by both 2 and 3, then we can say that it is divisible by 6. Let me take one more example, 27. Now first we'll check whether it is divisible by 2. So for that, what you have to see? You have to see the units place. So what is there in the units place? 7. So what should be there? 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, right? These, any of these numbers should be there, but here 7 is there. So this is not divisible by 2, not divisible by 2. Then whether it is divisible by 3, how you will check? You have to add those. 2 plus 7, 9. So 3, whether 3 is a multiple of, sorry, whether 9 is a multiple of 3, yes, right, 3 3 is 9. So 9 is a multiple of 3, so it is divisible by 3. So yeah, what should be there to here we have to check for divisibility by 6. To become it is divisible by 6, it should be divisible by both 2 and 3. Here only it is divisible by 3, it is not divisible by 2. So we can say that it is 27 is not divisible by 6. Let me take one more example. 2,97,144. You have to check whether it is divisible by 6. So what you will do? First you will check for divisibility by 2, whether it is divisible by 2. So you will see the units place. Unit place is 4, so we can say that it is 4 is in the unit place. So we can say that it is divisible by 2. Divisible by 2. Okay, first point. Then we have to check for divisibility by 3. So what you have to do? You have to add those. So 2 plus 9 plus 7 plus 1 plus 4 plus 4. So 2 plus 9, 11. 11 plus 7, 18. 18 plus 1, 19. 19 plus 4, 23. 23 plus 4, 27. So the sum is 27. Whether it is a multiple of 3? Yes, right. 3 9s are 27. So it is multiple of 3. So we can say it is 27 is multiple of 3. So we can say that it is divisible by 3. Since, so last conclusion, what? Since 297,144 is divisible by both 2 and 3, therefore 297,144 is divisible by 6. So it is divisible by 6. Students, take down some homework problems. First one, using divisibility test, determine which of the following numbers are divisible by 6. You have to check which of these numbers. There are E sub questions in this. Which is divisible by 6? You have to check. 1,258, 4,335, C, 61,233, 438,750, 639,210. Next, second one, they have given a box. What you have to do? You have to fill this box. How? Using divisibility test, determine which of the following numbers are divisible by 2, by 3, by 6, by 5, by 10. Say yes or no. You have to check these numbers. There are 5 numbers. You have to check the divisibility test for 2, 3, 6, 5 and 10. Well, if it is divisible, you have to mention yes. If it is not divisible, then mention no. Yes or no. You have to fill this table by yes or no. Students, all these questions in your homework book. Thank you.